FalcataPhalanx bringing you a battle footage on Rome Total War. Here's the quote of the video, you can read it if you want. As you see, I'm in command of the Romans. So yeah, here's my army. Consists of around, let's see, 6 legionary cohorts, 1 elite legionary first cohort, 2 Roman archers, 2 triarii, and 2 Praetorian cavalry. And this battle is fought in the Green Masterpiece. And I've managed to come up with a force of 1,041 troops. And my opponent came up with, I think, 1,400, around that much. And you see, I hardly came with any cavalry. I only came with 2 units. But I knew I was going to go against the Seleucid cataphracts. And it's kind of dumb for me to bring 2 units of these guys, but I made up for that. I made up for the lack in cavalry for triarii. So hopefully the odds will be even. So yeah, this is a pretty cool map. I actually like this map a lot. I'd actually like to visit a place like this. It's very nice. We have a lot of places like this in British Columbia. But here's the Seleucid army. Consists of 5 silver shield pikemen, 6 of these regular archers, and 2 Greek cavalry. They're hiding in the woods. Right now you can only see 1. He also has 5 cataphracts, so I was right. And he has a whole lot of archers. So and his name is Caesar of the IEC clan. So he's gonna move his men up a little bit. My plan here is to kind of just sit put and wait for him to come to me. It's because I have these guys hidden in the woods. So if he does happen to go after me, I could launch an easy attack on his guys while they're engaged with my Romans. So yeah. So his archers could definitely kick the crap out of my Roman archers. My Roman archers are just completely outgunned in this fight. Plus there's there's like a lot. They're just gonna wreak havoc on my archer line. But however, I'm not just gonna sit there. I'm gonna do what I can to dent up the Seleucids as much as I can to my Roman archers. I definitely expected them to die, so they lost around 5 men in that volley. They're gonna fire back with their own arrows, and these guys are already down to 50. These guys are down to 40 exactly. So yeah. For now, we're just skirmishing, and my archers are already they're already crumbling, and they're almost completely wiped out. This unit is down to 7. The other one is down to 12. But I've kind of had enough of this, so I'm gonna abandon my previous plan to stay put, and I'm gonna rush up my troops to push back his archer line, because I don't really want to get shot to death. And these guys are going to have to push back, or I'll wipe them out with my legionnaires. He's going to fire my legionnaires, but my legionnaires have the really big shields. Not many of them are going to die. So yeah, he does have a hill advantage, but I wasn't really worried about his hill advantage, because I have superior infantry. And the only thing that really makes the Roman infantry equal with the Hellenistic factions is that they have a Pila, and the Pila actually makes them more equal against the superior Macedonian Seleucid units, because these Seleucid units have a lot of numbers, and when you throw all that Pila, they get reduced by a lot. So the big fight's gonna begin. one of his units already rout. But I'll come out with his Greek cavalry. And come around, launch a hammer and anvil. Since Greek cavalry suck, they're not gonna rout anybody. So yeah. And when this battle started, I saw these guys. You know, they're kind of still exposed. So I knew about them, but I just wasn't worried about them. If they were cataphracts and they were hiding, then maybe I would have been pretty worried. But for now, I'm just not worried about his Greek cav. And I already took out his left flank, but he's gonna smash into my legionnaires with his cataphracts. And yeah, he's also throwing his cataphracts into the big infantry fight. So so yeah, it's a pretty bloody, pretty big mess. I popped my my Praetorians and Triarii out of the woods for reinforcements. Because I don't really know if my legionaries could take the heat of these guys. Over here, my two units of legionaries are surrounded, but I'm trying to relieve them with my Praetorian Cav. I see my Triarii gonna arrive as well. Just taking a while. So yeah, very vicious fight. And I'm gonna try and also help with my legionary first cohort unit, which is my general's in. Where's my general? I don't really know where he is. I don't know, he's probably fighting somewhere. Oh, right, there he is. And over here, my legionaries aren't really doing so good. My Triarii aren't really doing well at all, because they're not really good at fighting other infantry. There, my centurion kills the enemy general. It is time to press the attack. And he's gonna come back with some cavalry. But it's too late now. So right now there's a huge scramble for infantry superiority. But I have a lot of infantry left, and they're gonna do what they can and do fight extra hard. So yeah, fighting viciously. So the Seleucid line is gonna finally collapse. He has some cavalry left, but they're not gonna last as long. So all he really has is archers, and I'm just gonna cut them down. So I've nearly won the battle. So yeah. Nearly won the battle. Close victory. Good game to Caesar, the IEC clan. The Praetorian Cav killed 233, so that's a lot of it's a lot of sluices they killed. That's a lot. So yeah, good game. And I hope you guys enjoy this battle. See you later.